In 1993, one man at one event changed the face of mixed martial arts forever. His name?
Royce Gracie!
And using his family's Brazilian jiu-jitsu, he defeated three men in one night to become the very first Ultimate Fighting Champion. We saw this unimposing man dominate every opponent, and mixed martial artists everywhere suddenly realized they had a lot to learn.
Hi, I'm Royce Gracie, and I'm 4-degree black belt in Gracie Jiu-Jitsu, and I'm the current champion, and I'm here to defend my title.
The UFC evolved quickly. Fighters combined traditional striking with wrestling and submissions to develop the hybrid style we now call MMA. Gloves were added, weight classes, five-minute rounds, and the chaotic bare-knuckle brawls of the early days were replaced with sanctioned athletic events and world-class sportsmen. Today, the UFC is a household name and selling out arenas all across the globe. The elite warriors who compete here in the Octagon are as conditioned and as skilled as any athlete alive, and you are now part of it. Welcome to the Ultimate Fighting Championship.
Let's go, y'all. Only defended my title in the WFA twice. I decided to make my move to the UFC. A lot of people was telling me, man, you're not ready for the UFC. You're going to get your ass knocked out. I'm here to prove all y'all wrong, all y'all guys out there that don't think I'm really good at this game. Let's get this thing popping, man. I'm going up against the Crippler, you know. Chris Leben. Everybody know who this guy is. I'm going to get more into that a little bit later. Let's get into these announcements.
Coming up next, it's a middleweight matchup between the Ultimate Fighter's original bad boy, Chris Leben, and the King. Our Tale of the Tape is brought to you by Zenergy, powered by Zions, the official energy drink of the UFC.
Gentlemen, ready?
The King.
Ready?
Chris Leben.
All right, so let's talk about Chris Leben in the first round, guys. You know what I'm saying? Basically, this dude was one of the original dudes from The Ultimate Fighter. Like, if you don't know who Chris Leben is, you need to Google this dude. This dude was a fucking madman, yo. First of all, this dude always pissy drunk. You know what I'm saying? And he always in a confrontation with somebody. Now, check out that nice takedown I just did. A lot of people thought that I didn't know how to complete takedowns, man. I just know how to complete them at a specific time. You know, the time that's needed. Now, for the most of the match, I'm going to try to keep this on the ground. Seeing as though I know what Chris Leben is good for. He's good for, you know, strikes, you know, standing up, you know, and I don't want that, you know, so I'm gonna try to keep it on the ground as much as I can. I'm trying to break this dude ribs, you know, I'm trying to put this bad boy down, man. Now, a lot of people might have said, why did you come to the UFC, you know, with not that many fights under your belt? The way that I see it, I want to have a long and illustrious career in the UFC. I don't want to be in a WFA forever. You know, the WFA really isn't nothing nice. You know, the UFC is where everybody wants to be. So I decided to make the change, and now I'm here. Now, one thing is, you know, since this is my debut fight, and I'm going up against... since I'm going up against this guy, Chris Leben, let me push him off of me real fast. Hold on. There we go. All right. Now, since I'm going up against this guy, you see I'm going right back to the clinches, man. I don't want to try my chances with this dude, man. I know he has a crazy stand-up game, and I just want to work his body, man. My cardio still isn't up. I still have a lot of work to work on, so I'm just going, you know, send this guy right back to the ground. Now, of course, you know I'm a strike. You know, I'm not trying any submissions or anything with this guy because, like I said, my stamina isn't really that great. Now, as I'm working his body, you can notice that his stamina bar is going down more and more and more. So, but if you notice, every transition, mine's is going down as well. So, it's kind of crazy. But, you know, I couldn't get him out of here in the first round. So, of course, we're going to have to go to the second round. Hopefully, I can get this guy out of here. Now, it's not much going on right now. I'm trying to get through all the transitions. As you can see, I'm just button mashing on everything. So, the end of the first round is coming up, man. We got a few seconds left. Yeah, I can't get him out of here. Fuck.
Round one complete. Joe, we saw that round mostly centered around the ground game.
Yeah, it's a pretty interesting matchup on the ground, Mike. Both these guys are highly skilled, and both are looking to finish.
All day long, okay? I've got it all day long. Don't vary from the game plan. Are you paying attention to me?
Don't vary from the game plan. Right? Throwing that.
Let's take a look at the replay from that round, Mike. This was that counter. Such unbelievable timing on that. And look at the speed on this takedown here. So much athleticism. And here we see that exchange that ended in a solid takedown. Solid wrestling skills on display in that round, Mike.
You feel holding that guard. Bring out that combat, Lee. Get yourself.
The beautiful Ariani gets us set for round number two.
Gentlemen, ready? Ready?
All right, guys. Also, another thing that I don't understand. I don't know if Leben is on drugs right now. I don't know if he's taking anything. Because if you guys remember, after his fight that he lost to Silva back in 06, it seems like he was juicing for every fight. So he fought this dude named Bisping or some shit like that. And he, you know, tested positive for some shit. So I don't know, man. This dude might be juicing right now. Hopefully, oh, shit. What the fuck? All right. I'm riding the wall. I'm trying to get the fuck up, man. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, God damn. Oh, shit. I got it fast as shit. I thought that was it. Come on. There we go. Come on. Let me get this position. Come on. Come on. Oh, fuck. Yo, I hate trying to button mash this fucking button to get position. Oh, this shit is stupid. What the fuck? Come on, dude. Yes, got your back, bitch, nigga. All right, let's see. Yeah, he's got a hell of a guard going on right now. All right, he's in full guard. Fuck. All right. Oh, full mount on his bitch ass. Ah! Come on, come on, come on, come on. Just let my head free so I can fucking pummel you. Get off me. Ah. All right. All right, there I go. Yo, what's up with these pity-pat punches, man? This shit ain't gonna knock nobody out, dog. Yeah, y'all. You know what? You guys are right. I do need to learn some new moves. My moves are ass. Like I'm trying so hard to, you know, try to pump somebody. This dude in full guard. Oh shit. Oh shit. Get off me. Nah, I ain't falling for that one. Yo, these pity pad punches is ass right now, yo. Oh my god, I really need to learn some new moves. Yo, side control. Yeah, let me get these ribs. Let me get these fucking ribs. I want a full stack. Ah, shit. Never mind. I was about to say a full rack of ribs and shit. I can't get my leg free. There we go. Side control. There we go. Let me get that full rack of ribs. You know what I'm saying? With some of that sauce. You know what I'm saying? That hickory smoke. Ah, shit. I can't get my leg free. All right, we got about 30 seconds left in this round. All right, let me see if I can just go all out on him. Well, at least I'm actually winning the match, you know. At least I'm not losing. Oh, this round is over. I can't win this round. Fuck it.
Half guard. That's the end of round number two. Our fighters will move to the third and final round.
We saw some decent groundwork in that second round, Joe.
Yeah, these guys are very active on the ground. One mistake in this final round, and either fighter could finish it early.
Got to keep those hands up inside. The leg kicks are there. All right, the leg kicks are there.
Let's take a look at the replay, Mike. Here we see the fight get taken to the ground, steps right into the strikes. And some incredible power on that shot here, just connected perfectly. Some good groundwork in that round, Mike.
You're looking at the takedown, you're going back to the strikes. You're looking perfect.
There's Shandella getting set for round three.
Gentlemen, ready? Ready?
All right, I just got one question, guys. Why am I fighting Chris Leben? Ain't he supposed to be suspended for a whole year for having that oxycodone? Oh, whatever. Fuck it. Never mind. It is only a game. It's only right. But let me hurry up and get this dude to the ground. Come on. You already know what it is, man. Nice takedown. Ah, he keep grabbing my fucking head. All right. Half guard. Come on. Oh, my God. I wish I could do something more. I wish I had some nice elbow tricks or something that I can throw at this dude on the ground. Side control. Let me get that half rack. Back in the half guard. Oh, back to side control on his bitch ass. Let's go. Let me get them ribs. Yo, this was the softest match I have ever been in. Like, I know I'm just, you know, abusing the ground game right now, but where's my fucking haymaker blows and shit? Like, he's... Alright, let me just, you know, try to draw his body out. Yo, these pity pat punches are ass right now. Yo, I know this shit is probably boring to y'all as well. I know I wouldn't want to sit here for 15 minutes and watch this shit. I promise y'all, man, my next fight, at least get a nice submission or a knockout in early rounds or something. You know what I'm saying? This is the most realistic fight I've had my whole career. Shit. I'm really in the third round right now with 2 minutes left. Like, fucking half guard. Oh, he's riding the gate. Yeah, he's back up. Fuck it. Come on. I'm not letting your bitch ass go. You high? You're not going to start trying to, you know what I'm saying? Yep, there we go. Got you right back to the ground. I can live on the ground, man, for real. I could really sit up here and just, you know, go through transitions all match. Got the mount. Come on. This boy will not let go of my fucking head. Yo, I just want to pummel you. Come on, there we go. Oh, my God. This shit is horrible. We got 1 minute left. Of course, you could tell from his body damage, he looks nowhere near, you know, on his way out for a knockout. I'm so sorry, guys. I wish I could have brought a more hype gameplay and commentary. This shit is just making me sad my damn self. But check out for my next UFC video. I hope I get a knockout in that joint. 10 seconds left. It is what it is, guys.
That is the end of the third and final round. Joe, neither man embarrassed himself, but neither man really put on a show in that fight.
It wasn't the best fight we've ever seen, but it was a good one. Let's take a look at the replay of some of the action here, Mike. This was that counter. Such unbelievable timing on that. And this is the onslaught of strikes. Super aggressive right here.
The judges have rendered their scorecards. Bruce Buffer has the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 3 rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. The judges score it 29-28, 29-28, and 29-28, declaring the winner by unanimous decision, David the King!
The King is the winner.
Well, shit, at least I won the match. At least I'm still undefeated. You know what I'm saying? I still got a perfect record coming into the UFC, which is pretty good on advanced difficulty, I might say myself. I did throw a lot of punches. You know, you could tell that he didn't throw much because he was on his ass all day. No homo. all right. Let's see what's going on here. Okay, we already know what it is. I'm 11-0, baby. Let's go. Alright, got my cred up. You know what I'm saying? I'm ranked 12 after that. Nice. Yeah. Check out some bomb-ass knockouts right here, you guys. The links will be right there on top of the annotation of the vids. Don't forget the MSN. Show me love on Twitter and Facebook. Also, check out more of the playlists. I'm out of here. Oh, yeah, that little subscribe button over there. You can hit that too if you like. I'm out of here, y'all. Peace.